Welcome to my studio. I'm Linda Peterson. It's time for another Spellbinders Media Mixage video, and today's topic is charms. So I'm going to show you how to use the die templates to explore beyond. We're going to create an adorable miniature birdhouse charm. We're going to be using recycled cereal boxes because it's the perfect base for our birdhouse. And as you can see, I have two different colors of paper that I have applied to one side of the cereal boxes. Now, the dies that we'll be using today are the number 2 from the rectangles 1 and the houses 1. And I have those both placed face down over my paper on my cutting plate. You're going to finish your sandwich with your base plate and pass this through the Artisan X-plorer. You'll need to cut out 2 houses and 1 rectangle from the house paper, and then you'll need a separate rectangle for your roof. This is the rectangle that is going to become the sides, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to trim this down a little bit so it's the right height. So I'm going to trim off about 1/8 of an inch, just a little bit over, just like that. Now we're going to make our crease lines so that we can bend this to form the sides. And right here I have a little diagram that I want to show you because it shows where I have made these crease lines. So you're going to measure over 1/8 of an inch, 1/2 inch, 1 1/4 inches, and 1 5/8 inches. And you're going to make a score line on each of these lines. Now the pattern here that I have on the sides where this is 1/8 of an inch, and I have the X here and this 1/8 of an inch. These are the areas that you're going to put your double stick tape, just like I have done here. Now we're going to assemble our birdhouse, and as you can see on this one, I've already poked the little hole in the center for the little bird to peep out of. And you're going to take one of your houses then and just center it right down over the top. And you're going to bend at your crease line, bend your little flaps back, and you're going to apply your back. So now you have the beginning of your three-dimensional little birdhouse. The final steps are to add your roof and your bottom plate to your birdhouse. To create the bottom plate, I just set my birdhouse onto a piece of that covered cereal box and traced around it, left a little edge, and cut it out. I've also placed a very tiny hole right there in the center. This is the rectangle that I have covered with my paper on the one side. On the back side, you can see that I've marked the center and I've also poked a hole. I also have a score line down the center, which we're going to bend in half. Just like that. It's going to create the roof. So with a little bit of white glue, we're going to attach the roof. Set that on. You might want to let this dry for a little bit, but you're going to attach your base plate the exact same way by adding a little bit more glue to the bottom and then setting it down onto your base plate there. To make this into a charm, I have a jewelry head pin which has a little flat end on one end. Now if you want to hang a dangly from this, then you'll use an eye pin which has a loop. So I have a head pin. I've threaded it in the little hole and out the hole on the top. I'm just going to pull it to the bottom there, and with a pair of round nose pliers, I'm going to create a loop. And now you have your birdhouse charm. So take a look at how I've turned this into a pendant. I've used the aluminum metal from the Spellbinders Media Mixage line on this particular one. I've texturized it with one of the texture plates, added a few little charms and a chain, and it really makes an adorable pendant. So I encourage you to explore beyond and see what new ways you can discover to use Spellbinders die templates. You can check out their entire range on the website at spellbinderscreativearts.com. That's going to wrap it up for me today, but I'll be back again sharing more tips, techniques, and ideas, because the possibilities are endless when you explore beyond.